In programming, sometimes you need a variable that can be constrained to a small range of values. Such things are called enums, short for enumerations, and Python has its own version of this. The enum library, which comes standard with Python, lets you create enum types idiomatically and automatically. So let's take a look at some examples. Enums in Python are essentially classes. When you create an enum, you inherit from the enum class and assign the values you want, like this. Note that it's best to use all caps for the value names, as they are not supposed to change anyway. Now we can use the value as is, in this example, and we can get the name of the value and its underlying actual value this way. You can also perform comparison operations between enums, although if you want to do anything other than equality, you're going to need to refer to the underlying values themselves. In this case, the value for copyEdit, 2, is indeed greater than the value for draft, 1. Note that you shouldn't confuse an enum object with its underlying value. If we try to compare poststatus.draft with 1, they're not going to be considered the same. What we want to do is compare instead with the underlying value, this way. Now there's another, slightly more concise way to create an enum, which can also work if you want to create them programmatically. In this example, we supply the name of the enum and its values to the enum constructor. When we do this, the default behavior is to use an integer as the underlying value, and to start from 1 and go upwards. So the outputs we get for this version of the code, and all of their comparisons, are all still the same. Just bear in mind that when you do this, the order of the declarations for your enums will matter. So if you reorganize these declarations at any time, the underlying values will be different. For instance, if I took copyEdit and I moved it last, like this, and I reran this code, the underlying value for copyEdit will become 4 and not 2. Keep this in mind if you're storing references to these values externally, for instance, in a database. You don't want to inadvertently destroy their meaning elsewhere. Now, we don't have to use integers as enum values. It's just a convenient thing to do. We can also use strings. In this example, I'm using strings for the enum values as a way to provide information about their meaning. If we just print the status object, we get the enum's programmatic name, but the value will give us this actual string value, a form of documentation. This is handy if the value itself is not really as important. Another way to automatically create the values you need is to use the auto function, like this. This code generates the same results as the first example, but there is a catch, and it's the same as with the more concise declaration syntax, which is the order of the declarations matters for the underlying values. If again, we took copyEdit and we moved it to the last position like this, its value would become 4, as we saw with the earlier example. And again, you want to avoid that if you have external references to these values that aren't supposed to change. A few other things about enums are really convenient. For instance, you can access enum members by way of their names or values, like this. If you use square brackets for the accessor, as per a dictionary lookup, you can get an enum by its name. If you invoke it like a function call with a value, you can get the enum by its value. So to sum up, enums in Python let you create values constrained to a specific range, which you can address by name or their underlying value. And while you can create them programmatically or define them ahead of time, you always want to be cautious of inadvertently redefining their values so you don't break external references to them. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. Don't forget to follow Dev with Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.